The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 12, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on November 24, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
Sunasam, natsam neme janabhiva. Na chaiva na bhavishyama sarve vayam ataparam. Krishna is giving more enlightenment on the living entity, soul. Never was there a time when I did not exist. Nor you, nor all these kings, nor in the future shall any of us cease to be. Now, Krishna says that in the past I existed, so also you, and so also all the soldiers and the kings who have assembled in this fighting. They existed in the past. For the present, there is no question of asking, we are existing. And in the future also, it is not that we shall not exist. That means we shall exist. So, what is I, you, and others? I am individual person. You are individual person, and all others, they are also, each and every one of them, individual person. So, in the past, we are all individuals. At present, we are all individuals. And in the future also, we shall remain individuals. So, where there is question of merging, become one. Here Krishna says that in the past we are individual persons, in the present we are all individual persons, and in future also we shall remain individual. So the Mayavadi theory that impersonal, how it stands, neither God is impersonal, nor the living entities are impersonal. Every one of us, person. The difference between the Supreme Person and our personality is that He is all-powerful, we are limited. Our power is limited. Everything our limited. Anu Prabhu. He is great, we are small. He is infinite, we are infinitesimal. Very small. Otherwise, in other qualities, we are one. There is no difference. Satchidananda Vigraha, in eternity, in blissfulness and in knowledge, everything is there. But Krishna's knowledge and our knowledge differ. Just like Krishna says, Imam divasati yugam praktavan ahamad bayam. I spoke this yoga system, Bhagavad Gita, long, long ago to the sun god. Vivashan manabe praha. And the sun god explained it to his son Manu. And Manu, again, in his turn, he explained to his son Ikhaku. In this way, this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita is coming by the disciplic succession. So, Krishna says, I spoke. So it is millions and millions. at least 400,000 millions of time, 3 millions of years ago, according to the calculation of Manu. So Krishna said millions and millions of years ago, this Bhagavad Gita, he remembers. But Arjuna inquired from him, how can I believe that you spoke this Bhagavad Gita millions and millions of years ago to Sun God, because we are contemporary. Krishna and Arjuna, they are practically of the same age. So Arjuna was calculating as a human being about Krishna. That was his mistake. That was his not mistake. That was his inquiry to clear the mistake of power. We mistake Krishna as one of us, because Krishna comes down as human being. We, due to our lack of knowledge, poor fund of knowledge, we think Krishna is as good as we are. But actually it is not. Krishna is God. We are ordinary living entities. His knowledge, His power of remembrance, His power of knowing everything perfectly is different from ours. But unfortunately, we think God may be little greater than me. That is that Dr. Frog philosophy. We have explained several times. Kupa Mandukanna, the frog within the well, he is calculating the dimension of Pacific Ocean. So by this frog philosophical way, we cannot understand what is God. We must receive the knowledge from God Himself or from a person who knows God. Otherwise, there is no possibility. Now, according to Mahabharata philosophy, they say that there is no duality. It is a kind of illusion that we see difference between God and ourselves. That is Maya. Then Krishna is not advocating herewith about the impersonal feature of the Lord. He says, he is God Himself. He says, I was existing as I am existing now, and in future also I shall exist like this. So he was speaking as individual person. So in the past he says that I was individual person, and in the present he is individual person. So why these Mayavadi philosophers do not understand this direct version from the Supreme Personality of God? Because Asuri Bhavama Sita, the Mayavadi philosophers, they do not accept the supremacy of the personality of God. They think God is as good as they are. Therefore, they introduce themselves as Narayana. But according to Vaishnava philosophy, Narayana cannot be equal to any one of us. What to speak of us? Narayana cannot be equally estimated even with great demigods like Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva. Vaishnava Puran says, Jastu Narayanam Devam Brahma Rudradi Daivati Samaptena Vikheta Sa Pashandi Bhavet Dhruvam. anyone who calculates Narayan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, equal with such demigods, not what to speak of ordinary human beings, even big demigods like Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, he immediately becomes a passioned atheist. The Mahavadi philosophy, they put forward this argument that because we are now in Maya, we are thinking that we are different from God. But Krishna is making that such differentiation that he is making, he is saying, you and I and all these. So does it mean that Krishna is also covered by Maya or illusion? Because he is very clearly differentiating between him and the living entities, all individuals. So if the Mahavadi philosopher is right that this differentiation is due to our illusion, then we have to accept Krishna is also an illusion, because he is making differentiation. See, if Krishna is in illusion, then what is the use of taking his version? Because our proposition is that we have to take knowledge from the perfect person. So if Krishna is in illusion, then how he can become perfect person and the knowledge delivered by him is perfect? No, Krishna is not illusion, we are in illusion. Krishna is not illusion. Krishna cannot be in illusion. In the Vedas, in the Katha Upanishad, as well as in the Sita Satara Upanishad, it is said that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the maintainer of innumerable living entities. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Nitya Nityanam Chetana Chetananam Eka Bahunam Vidadhati Kama. There is Eka and Bahu. The Bahu, they are also Nitya and Chetana. That means we living entities. We are also Chetan and eternal. And Krishna is also eternal and Chetan. So far, the living symptoms and the eternity is concerned, both the living entities and God, Krishna, they are one. But the difference is that eka bahunam vidadhati kaman, that one, that chief one, he, although he is eternal and living force as we are, but he is the chief, he maintains all others. That is a version. Nitya nityanam chetanas chetananam eka bhunam jo vidadhati kaman tam atmastham je anupasanti dhirat tesam shanti sasatim netaresam. This is a version from Kathopanishad. Nitya nityanam, he is the supreme eternal amongst all the other eternal. Chetana Chetanana, he is the supreme living force amongst all other living forces. Eka bahunam jo vidadhati kaman, that one, singular number, Eka, he is providing, maintaining all other living entities. Tam atmastham, he is also in everyone's heart. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishtati. Tam Atmastham ja anupasanti dhira. Anyone who can perceive his presence, dhira, very highly learned or very gentle. Dhira. Dhira means who is not disturbed. He is called dhira. And there are others who are called adhira. Adhira means those who are disturbed. So those who are in the material world, they are always disturbed. And those who are on the spiritual platform, they are dhira. Dhira, dhira. About the Goswamis, it is said, Krishna kirtana gana nartana paro prima mritamuni dhi. Dhira dhira janap priyau priyakaro nirmasaro pujito. Sri Chaitanya kripa bharo bhuvi bhuvo bharavahantarako bande rupa sanatana ragujugo sri jiva gopalako. So, one who is in the transcendental position, he is dhira. Poet Kalidas, he has described dhira means, even in the presence of provocation, one who is not disturbed, he is called dhira. He has described our Lord Shiva. When Lord Shiva was being worshipped by Parvati, Lord Shiva was naked and Parvati was worshipping the Shivalinga, but he did not become agitated. Therefore, Kalidas has described dhira, dhira. One who is not the first disturbance is sexual disturbance. So anyone, although he is completely potent with all the potencies, but still he is not disturbed with sex impulses, he is called dhira. Actually, that is called brahmachari. Brahmachari is not, he is impotent. He can marry, he can beget children, but self-restraint, he is so self-restraint that he is not disturbed unless he deserves that I shall have sex and for begetting children. He is not disturbed. That is called dhira. That is not by seeing any woman or man one is disturbed. He is adhira. He is adhira. So dhira dhira janapriyo priyakaro nigmas. The Goswamis, they were equally respectable for the dhiras and the adhiras. So, a spiritual master, a Goswami, should be equally merciful both for the dhiras and the adhiras. Otherwise, he cannot become a preacher. Preacher has to meet so many fallen souls. So if he becomes disturbed, then he cannot preach. Therefore, dhira, this word is here. Anupasanti, tam atmasam ji anupasanti dhira. He is called dhira. Without being dhira, you cannot perceive the presence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead within your heart, because the God is there in Paramatma feature. But you have to become dhira without being disturbed. Then you can understand, here is Krishna within man. Premanyana churita bhakti vilochanena santas sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti yam shyama sundaram achinta gunasvarupam Govindamadipurusam Tavangmaya. This dhira can be possible when we develop love for Krishna. Then we become dhira. Otherwise it is not possible. Otherwise we shall be disturbed. Premanyana charita bhakti vilochane. And how we can see God? Not with these eyes. These eyes, but there must be some ointment that is called prema. Just like a mother sees his child, although not very beautiful, very beautiful, because she has got love for the child. Others, they are seeing the child not very beautiful. The mother, out of ecstatic love, sees the child very beautiful. So similarly, unless we have developed our love for Krishna, we cannot see the Supreme Personality of Godhead within our heart, not only within our heart, everywhere. Premanjana charita bhakti bilochanena santas sadaiva hridayeshu bilopayanti yam shyama sundaram atyanta gunasvarupam govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajam. The same Vedic truth given to Arjuna is given to all persons in the world who pose themselves as very learned but factually have but a poor fund of knowledge. This is poor fund of knowledge, that God and I, we one. Now, because we are illusioned, we are thinking that God is different from me, but when the illusion is over, then I and God become one. This is Mayavadi theory, monism. But actually, this is not clear knowledge. God is always distinct from me. He is the supreme. It is not that we are equal to God. We are equal to God in quality, not in quantity. Therefore, those who are thinking that they are equal to God in every respect, they are illusion. Maya aparita jnana. They have been designated by Krishna as Mayaya Aparita Jnana. Although they appear to be very learned, scholars, but the essence of the knowledge is taken away by Maya. Therefore, they say that God and ordinary human being is the same. Maya Aparita. This is called Asuri Bhava. Asuribhava means not to accept the supremacy of the Lord, but think Him as one with all individual souls. But that is not the fact. That is poor fund of knowledge. Actually, when one becomes advanced in knowledge, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, bahunam janmanam ante, in due course of time, after many, many births, when he actually comes to the platform of knowledge, he can understand that Vasudev is great and I am small, I am insignificant. Therefore he surrenders. Vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudurla bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mang prabhadrat. This is the sign of knowledge. When one surrenders to Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, it is to be understood that he has actually attained knowledge. Otherwise, it is ignorance. To think of Krishna, an ordinary person, as equal, is not knowledge, it is illusion. So, anyone who takes shelter of Krishna by the words of Krishna, believing. So, just like Krishna says, Mamikam saranam vraja, manmana bhava mad bhakta, mad jaji mang namaskuru. Krishna orders that you surrender unto me, you become my devotee, you always think of me, manmana, mad bhakta, you become my devotee, mad jaji, you worship me, you offer your obeisances unto me. The persons who are in poor fund of knowledge, they think it is too much. Krishna is demanding too much. It is sophistry. That is not sophistry. That is the real position. Otherwise, without surrendering to Krishna, if you think yourself that you are Krishna, that is an illusion, avishuddha buddha, contaminated intelligence, avishuddha buddha, jenne ravindakha vimukta manin, tai astabhavat avishuddha buddha, because they cannot understand Krishna, so their knowledge is not perfect, or not purified. Knowledge perfect is there in every living entity, but it is contaminated by the contact of Maya. So one who can understand the position of Krishna and himself, he is called Mukta. Mukta means liberated. Mukti means to know perfectly what is our relationship with Krishna. That is called Mukta. Antavatvaime deha nitya sukha sarina a anashina aprameyasya tasmad yuddha sabhav. Yuddha, fighting, Arjuna was kshatriya. It is his duty, because here in this material world, violence is also required. Violence, because everyone is competitor, everyone is trying to become the supreme. So there will be violence. Just like in your state at the present moment, there is violence because one party is trying to become supreme than the other. That is going on everywhere, all over the world. The struggle for existence, everyone is trying to become supreme than the other. So there must be violence. So, expecting that there will be violence, the kshatriya class requires. That's like in the state, expecting that there will be violence, therefore the police department is maintained. The military department is maintained. So you cannot avoid violence from this material world. It is useless proposal. Our Mahatma Gandhi tried to stop violence. He started the non-violence movement. But actually, he had to die by violence. So, Kshatriya, they are trained up to violence, to become violent, to stop violence. That is required. Therefore, Krishna advises, don't try to become non-violent, because tasma yuddhasya bharata. Don't think that by killing the body, your grandfather or your nephews and your brother on the other side, they will be finished. No. They will live. The body may be destroyed, na hannate hannamane sarire, but actual soul is transmigrated. According to Vedic philosophy, if a kshatriya dies in proper fighting, then he is immediately transferred to the heavenly planet. Because he sacrifices his body for right cause. Formerly, the fight was not a very trifle thing. After much consideration, then fighting or war was declared. Just like the fighting between the Kurus and the Pandavas, first of all, there was great endeavor to stop the fight. Krishna himself became the messenger and was going from this party to another, because Krishna, both the parties were Krishna's family relatives. So he wanted to stop and mitigate the misunderstanding by mutual settlement. But it was not possible. The Duryodhana's party said that we are not prepared to spare even a small piece of land which can hold the tip of the needle, Suchagrabham, then it was decided there must be fight. That fighting was meant for the Kshatriyas. Formerly, there was no democracy, the so-called democracy. Democracy means that there was one king only, now there are hundreds of kings. One king and few ministers, now there is one governor, three dozen secretaries and three dozen, so many things. So it is overburdened. The tax is overburdened because there are so many officers, they have to be sumptuously paid, so tax is required. So in this age, Kali Yuga, finishing the monarchical system, the people have accepted the democratic system, but it is not very much improvement, because the state expenditure has very much increased, and people are very much overburdened with taxes. Krishna advises that tasmād yuddhasya bhārata. Don't think that your grandfather or the other party relatives, they will be destroyed by fighting. It is not the fact that by destruction of the body, the soul is destroyed. Real purpose is Bhagavad Gita, that we should understand that the soul is always existing. Even hanna hannati hannamani chari. Jayanang vetti hantaram jastainang mannati hatam. Ubhauta na vijani to nayang hanti na hannati. There is another example. Krishna says, because the soul is immortal, eternal. So, if somebody kills somebody, the body is destroyed, but the soul is not destroyed. So, if one thinks that I have killed him, he is finished, he is also foolish. One who thinks that if I am dying in the fight, then I will be finished. No. Ubhauta na vijanita. Both of them are ignorant. Ubhauta na vijanita. Nayam hanti na hannati. The living soul is never killed, neither he can kill others. For duty's sake, of course, when there is fight, that is called dharma-yuddha. Dharma-yuddha, by the order of the Supreme, just like Arjuna was fighting, by the order of the Supreme, that is dharma-yuddha. If there is no sanction by the dharma, there is shastra, injunction, in this case, fighting should be there. In this case, there should be no fighting. So, one who follows the principles of regulation in the Vedas, that is called dharma yuddha. Even there is fight, there is religion, there is fight. Even by killing and being killed, two kshatriyas are fighting, either he kills or he is being killed. In both ways, they are promised. That will be expressed. That's why Arjuna was advised that, my dear Arjuna, why you are hesitating to fight? Both ways you will be benefited. If you can kill your enemies, then you get the kingdom, you enjoy. And if you are killed, then you are promoted to the heavenly planet. So where is your loss? Where is your loss? This is the instruction given. A kshatriya who is fighting for the real cause as sanctioned by the dharma shastra, then both ways he is profited. If he becomes victorious, he is profited, but if he is killed in the battle, he is also profited. Both ways. Jayanang vetti hantaram jasainang mannati hatam ubhautau na vijanita nayam hanti na hannati. Then the next part, he clearly explains, na jayate mriyate va tadasi. Nayam bhutya bhavitabana bhuya ajo nitya sasato yam purana na hannate hannamani sarire. This soul, do not think that soul is born. No. As God is ever existing, the soul is ever existing. It is not. There is no question of birth. And when there is no question of birth, there is no question of death. Because we experience anything, anybody who has taken birth, he dies. Nobody will live here. So, if the soul has no birth, there is no question of death. And as Krishna, God is eternal. Advaita achyuta anadi ananta rupam adyam purana. Purana means old. Because Krishna is the original person, that he must be purana, the oldest. Older than Brahma, because Brahma is given birth by Krishna. Therefore, Krishna has been addressed in the Bhagavad Gita as Prapitamaha. Brahma is called Pitamaha, the grandfather. And Prapitamaha means the father of the grandfather. So Krishna has been addressed as Prapitamaha, father of Brahma. Therefore, he is Adipurusha. Actually, within this creation, Lord Brahma is the original person, because he was first born. There was no other person before him. But then he is given birth by Narayana, from the abdomen of Narayana, in the lotus flower. Therefore, he is the father of Brahma, Prapitamaha. So Krishna here says, Because that Mayavad philosophy is also nullified here. Because here it is said, najayati mriyate va tadasi nayam bhutya bhuvitava na bhuya. Mayavad philosophy says that the living entity has become separated on account of illusion, not become separated. There is no separation, but it is illusion. He is thinking I am different from God. But Krishna says, mamaivamsa jiva bhuta, jiva loke sanatana. There is amsa, part and parcel of God. He is sanatana. Not that being covered by illusion, he is thinking I am separate. He is separated always. Sanatana. That is the statement of the Vedas. Separated, although separated, quality one, but that separation, that fragments of Krishna, that is Sanatana. It is not that by Maya we are fragmental, separated. When we are liberated, we merge into the body or the fallen sama. We are separated perpetually. Although we are eternal, but we are perpetually vibhinnansa. In the Varaha Purana, it is said, vibhinnansa, separated part and parcel. So we should understand very clearly that although we are eternal, part and parcel, but we are separated. Separated in this sense that we are, every one of us, an individual, not merged into the existence. Everything is existing. In the Bhagavad Gita, I find, Mastani sarvabhutani naham teshu avasthita. Everything is existing in him, Krishna, but still Krishna is not the living entity. Thank you very much.
Bhakti, if we chant Hare Krishna mantra, then we come to our perfection. At the present moment, we are illusion. Just like every one of us thinking that I am this body. Otherwise, why there is so much fighting? Everyone is thinking, I am this body. This bodily concept of life is maya, illusion, or ignorance. So, the whole process is to drive away the ignorance. Drive. That is called jnana. We are in the ajnana. Ajnana timirandhas. Jnananjana salataya chakshur militam jena tasmai sri gurave nama. Every one of us is covered by the darkness of ajnana. What is that ajnana? I am this body. I am Indian, I am American, I am Andhra, I am Bengali, I am this, I am that. So there is fighting due to the ajnana. So first of all, we have to drive away this ajnana. Therefore, Krishna is teaching Arjuna that you are not this body, you are spirit soul. This is the first spiritual instruction by the authority to anyone, that you are not this body. So, by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, it is the medicine recommended in the Shastra, Cheto Dharpana Majanam, that dust of ignorance is moved. He can understand that I am not this body, I am spirit soul, part and parcel of Krishna. My duty is to serve Krishna. In this way he becomes enlightened, graduate.
In the past we were existing, in present we exist, in future we exist. In what form is
life now? Just like you have dressed now, covered yourself with some type of dress. So if you change your dress, does it mean that you are finished? Try to understand. You are now in my presence, dressed in a certain type of covering. Now if you change this covering, does it mean you are finished? Similarly, this body, this material body, has been explained as dress. So if I change my dress, now suppose I am now a human being and I change my dress to become a demigod, or I change my dress to become a dog, it does not mean that I am finished. I have simply changed my dress according to my karma. Karmana daivanetrena jantar diha upapati. By your karma, you will have a dress. After that, as it is explained in this verse, na hannate hannamane sarire. The living soul is not destroyed after the destruction of this body. Therefore he remains, and his finer dress, subtle dress is there, mind, intelligence and ego. So according to the composition of his mind, he develops another gross dress. This is the process. So, you spirit soul, you are always the same, although you are changing dress. Our problem is that we are perpetually changing dress, but our desire is to have a permanent life. That is spiritual education. You can have this permanent life, permanent dress, permanent knowledge, if you become free from this dress-changing problem. That is karma.
Sir,
The Krishna consciousness movement is to stop this business of dressing. Yes? Huh?
Do you mean to say that Krishna
is also karma wrong? No. That's now
you have put the example that as we change our dresses, Krishna will also be changing the form.
What is that? Explain.
So just now you are comparing that as we change our dresses, Krishna will also be changing.
Why? Why I am saying? I have never said.
Excuse me, this question was, Krishna was, will be, and he is in what form?
Krishna, as we have got distinction between the body and the soul, Krishna has no such distinction. Krishna is completely soul. And if we think that Krishna is like us, that is forbidden. Abhijananti mana mura tano manasim tanuvas. Because Krishna comes before us, just like a human being. If we think that he is also like me, then you are ass. Krishna does not change, he says. No. Otherwise, Krishna could not say that millions and millions of years ago, I spoke this philosophy to the sun god. Because we change our dress, we forget what I was, what you were in your past life. Because you have changed the day.
The fundamental question of our interest is to know soul.
Yes.
What is the form and what is the definition of soul and how to know what is soul?
We are describing. Na jayate naam yate. Soul is never born, soul never dies, soul is eternal, nitya shashvata, na hannate hannamani sarire. Even after the destruction of this body, the soul is not destroyed. These are the education.
This concept of knowing the thing, you are just describing the qualities of the soul. If you can say mango is very sweet, color is like this, but there is a request to taste the mango. So I want to realize the soul, what is the shortest
there? There is mango, but you have no eyes to see it. That is the difference. Soul is there. That's like we have begun our instruction. Dehi nasmin jatha dehi. There is dehi. There is the soul within this body. Krishna says. So we have to accept Krishna's authority. You cannot see the soul. That does not mean there is no soul. What is the value of your eyes? You cannot see so many things. Because you cannot see the soul, it does not mean there is no soul. We have to accept the authority. Because your eyes are imperfect. Because there is a proof, as soon as the soul is gone, you are dead body. That is the proof. But you must be qualified to know. That I have already explained, that you must become tatviddhi panipatena paripasnena sivaya. You must approach to a person who knows by surrender, not by challenge. You cannot know about soul and God by this challenging spirit. You have to become a submissive. You have to accept a spiritual master who knows, then you know. It is not that in a meeting by challenging you can know. No, that is not possible. That you have to search out. If you are fortunate, you will get. Chaitadvaita, that we are explaining. Yes, dvaita and advaita, just like this finger is my finger. So it is part of this body. You can say this finger is also body. But at the same time, the finger is not the body. Is it clear? You cannot say this finger is the whole body. But at the same time, you can say, yes, finger is body. If you say, this is my body, there is no wrong, because finger is also part of the body. But if you say that the finger is body, that is also wrong. This is Daitya. It is simultaneously one and different. Similarly, the soul and the Supreme Lord equal in quality. The Krishna says, Mamaivans, the small particle of gold is gold. That is Advaita. You cannot say, because it is small particle of gold, you cannot say it is iron. It is gold. That is Advaita. But the gold mine and the gold earring, there is difference. You cannot say the gold earring is as good as the gold mine. That is Advaita. So in this way, as so far our spiritual existence is concerned, we are one. But so far our energies are concerned, that is different. That is the Advaita. You have no such big energy as God has. In that sense, you are different.